There's an old saying that a lecture is simply a setting in which the notes of the professor become the notes of the students without passing through the minds of either.
In a traditional lecture, you can sometimes have the dismaying feeling that what you're saying is just washing over the room with no real effect on the students.
A colleague and I designed a new course. We thought things went well, but we found out at the end of the course that fewer than half of our students could answer a question that we thought was sort of fundamental at the basis of this course.
It was a couple years after I won the Nobel Prize when I realized that there were ways to make teaching far more effective.
The Carl Wieman Science Education Initiative brought together resources and an organizational plan to change the way we teach science and mathematics such that our students learn more.
The three steps essentially are: decide what students should learn, measure what it is that they are learning, and decide what opportunities we can provide so they move toward expertise. How are we going to change our teaching practice to try the next time to do a better job and collect more evidence and iterate toward improvement?
When we started, nobody knew who we were, nobody knew what we were trying to do. We started to see some successes. The courses that we worked on worked better. And we got to the point where professors wanted to work with us. I remember at about year four, we took a professor's course out of the plan just because we thought we were running out of time. That professor flew into our office and said, why can't I work on the class? I want my class to be transformed.
Teaching fellows play a huge role in all of the steps of transformation. They watch you in the classroom, seeing what you're doing, and give you suggestions about things you could be doing differently.
What's the best way to
get
do that?
It.
Because I find if I pose it, someone tell me the answer, it's going to be one of the same three students who eventually says it every time.
The best combination is if they can talk to themselves to come to an answer, then you go
over time, as you repeat and change and tweak and improve, you get to a place where you have an approach that really works for your students. And that's what's great about it.
Depending on what's happening in the room, student engagement goes up and down. If I talk myself for longer than about 10 minutes, the engagement goes down and down and down until I do something that actively involves the students.
So for some people, that might be using clickers in a large classroom where you get a lot of people that are able to think on a problem at once. It might be having short activities. It might be having students do homework in a different way so they were prepared to come to class and answer questions. The key with all of them is that the students engage with the material.
My classes are large. I have 300 roughly students in my classroom, and so the big change in attitude is understanding that a large classroom can be active. If I've projected a question up on the board with a clicker, I can instantly look up at the classroom and know that they're engaged because students will be pointing up in the air, looking at different parts of the question, participating, communicating, grappling with the material.
To a large extent, this was about culture change. It's no longer acceptable to teach in a traditional sage on a stage manner.
Harvard's copying a lot of what's being done here, Stanford where I am now, Cornell's doing a lot, University College London. It's the model now that the world's starting to look to for how you improve teaching of science. Your faculty are gonna love doing this. That's why you should do it, and your students are gonna learn more.
UBC is now recognized as a leader in STEM education around the world, but perhaps more importantly, the impact is that tens of thousands of students learn more each year here at UBC, thanks to these new techniques employed in the classroom.